Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is Share Your Password, Go to Jail. This week, the Electronic Freedom Foundation, or EFF, as well as the media, seem to make a lot of detail about this story on how you might go to jail if you share your password, such as sharing your Netflix password with your wife. This is all based on a U.S. court case against someone named David Nocell. Now, I'm no lawyer, and I can't go into this complex case in a lot of detail, but here it is at a high level. Basically, this guy named David Nocell worked for an executive recruiting firm. He eventually resigned from that firm, but he did continue working for them for a short period of time after on a contractor basis. After he completely left them, he started his own competing recruiting firm, and he eventually also solicited three other employees that worked at the previous recruiting firm. However, more importantly, those three other employees apparently knowingly and willingly shared their password with him, and he used those passwords to actually take a lot of information from the other recruiting firm. And last week, a U.S. Court of Appeals made a ruling against Nocell on this case based on the Computer Fraud Abuse Act, or CFAA. And basically, according to the EFF, the court ruled against him because they interpreted that it was illegal for those users to give him the password for him to use because that constitutes unauthorized access. So now the EFF and the media are pointing out, does this make it illegal for you to share your Netflix password with your wife or share your email password with someone in your family? Now, personally, I normally agree with the Electronic Freedom Foundation. A lot of the things they fight for, I tend to fall on the side of them. But in this particular case, I actually think they're overblowing this particular issue. In this case, I think what Nocell and those employees did was illegal. Giving an ex-employee access to a company's network to actually take data that he uses to compete with them seems obviously bad in my personal opinion, no matter what law you use to prosecute it. Now, the EFF seems to be suggesting that the interpretation in this particular case will set a precedence where lawyers can always use a shared password as proof of illegal activity, and I think that's kind of silly. The whole idea that you sharing your email password with your wife if you own that email account seems silly to me. To me, I think the big difference has to do with who owns the asset the account is for. In this case, if you're an employee of the company, the employee is giving you or extending you personally trust to that company's information. Because you don't own that information, the company does, you shouldn't be authorized to extend that trust to anybody else. I'll give it to someone outside the company. However, when you own an email account, if Corey Nachreiner owns an email account and it's my data, then it is okay for me to extend my trust and give it to somebody else. So I actually think it's okay, I don't recommend it, but I think it's okay legally to share my own email password, but it's not okay for me to share my corporate email password with my wife. Now, a lot of other news stories are talking about Netflix and HBO Go as an example, and that's kind of a different case because the access Netflix is giving you is to somebody else's content that they're only licensing to you. So it may not be legal for you to let other people get access to that particular content that you do not own. Anyways, this is kind of an interesting case. I actually think the EFF and the media are kind of overblowing the situation. I don't think the government's going to start prosecuting us for sharing our bank or our email passwords with our wives, especially because we own the assets to both those accounts, unlike our passwords for our company or passwords to someone else's stuff. But in any case, it is very, very interesting. The one thing I do agree with EFF on is that the current CFAA, the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, is very generic in general. When laws have language that's too generic or general, it actually makes it easy to interpret many different ways. And it's better for laws to have very specific language so that they don't get interpreted other than how they were intended. So in any case, it's an interesting story. If you have thoughts on this, if maybe you do side with EFF, I'd love to hear your comments on why you do. Again, in this particular case, I think they're kind of overblowing the shared passwords. That's it for today's story. Thank you for watching.